Hello friends, welcome to Wisdom Jobs. This is Rupesh Jadhav again. Today I have with a different question and different topic. The topic is related to plate tectonic theory, but the more important is about plate boundaries. Okay, so before starting for that, our today's topic, please subscribe the channel Wisdom Jobs. And also if you like the video, if also you don't like, you have to give the like because my videos are good. So you have to give like, comment and share those videos to your friends. And this video is very much important for the students who are preparing for 10th, 12th graduation level. Okay, so obviously the topic is in 10th standard also. And for various competitive exams also, it is very much important because questions comes in on this particular topic in various way. Okay, so let's start without wasting the time. According to the theory of plate tectonic, when some plates comes towards each other, okay, try to understand the part. I am not explaining the plate tectonic theory. I will make separate video on that. But now I am explaining only the question. When some plates comes towards each other, okay, which of the following is formed? Which of the following is formed? It is regarding the boundaries, okay. Whether it is a convergent boundary, divergent boundary, transform boundary, or none of the above, okay. Try to understand. According to the theory of plate tectonic, when some plates comes towards each other, which of the following is formed? Actually, I can say which of the following boundary is formed. Okay, so is it convergent boundary? Is it divergent boundary? Is it transform boundary? Or none of the above? Okay, this is our question. Now, let's check out one by one. So the first part, okay. Convergent boundary. What is convergent boundary? Okay, when two plates comes together, now they can come together, okay, it is known as convergent boundary. Okay, this is one plate and this is another plate, okay, both are coming together in this way, so they are converging. This plate is converging with this plate. Okay, so this is what convergence boundary. The impact of the colliding plates. Now it is clear that they are colliding on each other as they are approaching towards each other. This is a one plate and this is another plate. Both are approaching towards each other. The boundary forming here. Okay, these, let's consider these are the boundaries which are forming here are convergent type. They are converging. Okay, now how might it be? Now, before that, you have to consider that the plates. Now, plates, two plates. Now, actually, plates are only of two types. One is continental and another one is oceanic. So, if we take the combination, if we are going to make the combination of these two plates, how it will be? Number one, continental. And continental, we are talking about the convergent, okay. So continental plate approaching towards each other, okay. Then number two, it can be continental and oceanic, both are approaching towards each other. Number three, oceanic and oceanic. Okay, so these are the combination of these two plates in convergent manner. Okay, so continental plate and continental plate coming together towards each other. Continental and oceanic plate coming towards each other. And oceanic plate coming towards each other. So this will be the combination. Basically, plates are of two types, A continental and B oceanic. But the combination is of three types. So how it would be, what it will be, what will be the result of this collision? They are colliding on each other. Okay, now number one, ocean, when two oceanic plates collide each other, island arcs and ocean trenches forms. Okay, now how, let's consider this as an ocean plate, okay, and this as another ocean plate. one ocean and another ocean. As you can see, I have drawn two different oceanic plate with different thickness. Okay, let's assume this is thick, this is the thickness, its thickness is T1 and here the thickness is T2. Okay, you can see that the thickness T2 is greater than thickness T1. Okay, so in such manner, this oceanic plate may subduct. Okay, so this oceanic plate may subduct below this plate because this one is thicker and this one is little bit thinner. Okay, so it is going to subduct. So in that case, oceanic trenches will be formed. Here, what is going to be output? The output is trenches. Here it is, the trench form. In simple term, I can say the trench. What is exactly trench? In simple word, it is like a valley formed on the continent. Bas itna abhi ke liye. Okay, so the trenches, here it is oceanic trenches. It will form ocean trenches and island arc. So ocean trench, you will find it in Pacific Ocean like Mariana Trench or Philippine Trench. Okay, so that point, and island arc again the Indonesia, like that. So when they are going to collide, they will form the island arc. So this was about the combination ocean ocean. Both are coming towards each other, colliding towards each other. Okay, now second, ocean continental. This is oceanic plate. Okay, and this is continental plate. Obviously, continental plate will be thicker than oceanic plate because there will be water. Okay, so oceanic continental. It results in mountain ranges. For example, Andes. Okay, so it is going to be, again, it is going to subduct. Volcanic mountain will be there. The oceanic material will melt. Here it is going to melt. Okay, then it is coming out by other way in the form of magma and forming a mountain. This is what? Magma. Okay, and here it is forming mountain range. For example, Andes. Okay, Andes mountain, where here it is South America and here it is Pacific Ocean, Southern Pacific Ocean plate, continental plate. Okay, it is subducting, the material is melting, and then it is coming up by means of this point here. Okay, and forming a mountain. Here it is Pacific Ocean, Southern Pacific Ocean. Okay, or sea floor trench, as I have told you, again this will become, if now it is not Andes, okay, trenches, sea floor trenches. Okay, or a chain of volcanoes, again the same example, Andes mountain. Okay, a chain of volcano. So it would give, if ocean and continental are coming, so mountain ranges, a sea floor trench, a chain of volcano. Okay, now the third combination, that is continental continental. Okay, now continental continental, one continent, another continent, continent one, continent two. Okay, so it results in large mountain ranges but not volcanic. Here it was ocean and continent results in volcanic mountain ranges. But when two continental plates come towards each other, they results in large mountain ranges. For example, Himalaya. Okay, here this is Indian plate and this is Eurasian plate. So both come towards each other and forming Himalaya. Okay, then another point is, it will lead in formation of earthquake. So as you might be knowing, Himalayan region is earthquake prone region also. Okay, very high earthquake prone region, because this Indian plate is still moving and colliding over the Eurasian plate. Eurasian plate is stable, okay, but this Indian plate is moving, okay. It is continuously colliding on this plate, which results in earthquake, okay. Then at convergent boundary, continental crust is created and oceanic crust is destroyed. If you remember, here the continental crust, it has been created, but in case of oceanic, okay, this is oceanic plate. Every time we have seen, okay, this is continental plate, it is going to destruct. In ocean also, it is going to destruct, okay. So oceanic crust is, continental crust is created and oceanic crust is destroyed. So keep it in mind, okay. After studying throughout the plate tectonic theory, we are not able to tell actually what is happening at which point of which type of boundary. So at convergent boundary, these things we will get, okay. Now let's go to other part. Before that, our question was the theory of plate tectonic when each other comes towards each other, which of the following is formed. So here we came to know that convergent boundary is going to form. The correct answer is convergent, when come together, okay. So when come together, convergent boundary is going to form, okay. Now let's go for other part, okay. A divergent boundary. Now what is divergent boundary? Divergent, the name itself says, it is diverging, it is going apart from each other. Earlier they were close, now they are separating, okay, in opposite direction, exactly opposite direction. It occurs when two tectonic plates move away from each other. So one tectonic plate, okay, and second tectonic plate, okay. It may be again oceanic, continent, or oceanic continent. So it is moving away. In divergent, it is moving away, and convergent, it is moving towards each other. So convergent is moving towards each other. This is convergent boundary. While as this has divergent boundary, this is divergent, this is convergent, okay. So it moves away from each other, which results in, now what it results? It results in earthquake, whether it may be oceanic, continental, it is resulting in, number one, earthquake, because you know in earthquake the earth gate, in that cracks are developed. How the cracks are developed? Because at that point it is diverging at two different point, okay, two different direction. So earthquake. Then magma of molten rock rises from the earth's mantle. Now let's consider, okay, this is one plate and this is another plate, okay, plate one, plate two. So magma from the molten rock rises from the earth's mantle to the surface, solidifying to create new oceanic crust. It means it is oceanic plate 1 and oceanic plate 2. Here there is ocean, okay, and this results in, earlier it was not there, but due to coming out from the inner part, it is moving in both direction, okay. So new oceanic crust is forming. Here it leads to the formation of oceanic crust, okay. New landform is being formed by means of divergent boundary, and let me tell you, due to convergent boundary between oceanic plate, it is no new landform form. But when it is continent and continent coming towards each other, if there is geosyncline present, again I will explain what is geosyncline, it is leading to the formation of mountain like Himalaya, okay. So here magma, this magma which is coming out from the mantle to the surface, solidifying to create the new crust. Other one is rift valley, one part and other part moving towards in different direction, it results in formation of rift valley. For example, we can say that this is Vindhya range and this is Satpura range. So in that, here the river Narmada flows, okay. Narmada flows through rift valley. Narmada river or Son trough. Narmada Son trough. Okay, so rift valley is forming. Then mid oceanic ridge. Now again, this is ocean, this is ocean floor, this one, and this one is again ocean floor. Okay, let's consider this as Atlantic Ocean. Example, Atlantic Ocean, in which the one oceanic plate and another oceanic plate both are diverging. They are moving in different direction. Why? Because the magma coming up is pushing this plate in this direction and this one is pushing this in this direction, or it is every time it is going to get deposit over this part. Okay, so due to this magma, it is getting pushed in opposite direction. In this way, here we will have ridge. Ridge means the mountain. If there is one mountain and this is we called as peak, it is called as peak. But if there is continuous chain of mountain, you just join all the peaks, it will be in a continuous way like this. Okay, all are mountains, so this become ridge. In the same way, this become ridge, but again it is in the ocean. Okay, it is in the ocean, and if it is in mid, so it is mid oceanic ridge. Okay, now if it is in Atlantic Ocean, its name will be mid Atlantic ridge, mid Atlantic Ocean oceanic ridge. Okay, for example, if you check out the map of Atlantic Ocean, you will realize with little bit dark color of blue, dark color. Okay, there is one like this, blue or light blue. Okay, this might be blue, so this might be lighter one, but this is generally darker one. So it is what? S shape mid Atlantic ridge. Okay, here there you will find the equator. So this is what, when divergent boundary is there, at divergent boundary we will find these things. Okay, let's check out again what we will find at which point. At divergent boundary, earthquake. Then at divergent boundary, new oceanic crust. At divergent boundary, rift valley, mid oceanic ridge. In convergent boundary it was ocean trenches, island arcs, mountain ranges or volcanic mountain ranges, or again trench, a large mountain ranges, earthquake occur in convergent boundary also and in divergent boundary also. Okay, again continental crust is created. It is created, continental crust is created and oceanic crust is destroyed. Okay, so let's move towards the third part, that is transform boundary. Okay, again the transform boundary. Before going to that, let's check out, this is plate 1, this is plate 2. Okay, they are coming towards each other, that is what, forming convergent boundary. Okay, this is plate 1, this is plate 2, it is moving away, it is what, forming divergent boundary. Now let's consider ki one plate is like this and another plate is like this. One is moving in this direction, this one, plate 1 is moving in this direction, and plate 2 is moving in this direction. So they are not touching to each other. At some point it may happen like grinding, they are touching little bit, but it will be like grinding. Okay, like this. So it is, one plate is moving, this one and another one, so they are moving like this. So some touching may be there, so, or otherwise just moving like this. Okay, so in that case, here two plates sliding past each other forms a transform boundary. This is what, transform boundary, which results in rocks that line the boundary are pulverized as the plates grind along, creating a linear fault valley. So here a valley, you can see here a valley is formed, and it is totally from this point to this point, it is linear valley. Okay, or undersea canyon. If this we talk about, so if this is one plate and this is another plate, they are moving, this plate is moving in this direction, this plate is moving in this direction. Okay, so here the canyon may form, undersea canyon. Okay, again in earthquake is present in every boundary, whether it may be convergent boundary, earthquake will be there, whether it may be divergent boundary, earthquake will be there. Okay, crust is cracked and broken at the transform margins. Okay, so crust is little bit cracked, if they are touching each other they will crack and get broken, but it is not created or destroyed. Okay, so it is not creating any other landform, only of the linear fault valley, which will be due to their presence, it automatically there will be a valley, linear fault valley, linear valley. Okay, so in that way this is the difference between all the three boundaries. Again our question was, according to the theory of plate tectonic, when some plates comes towards each other, which of the following boundaries formed? So it is convergent, coming towards each other, one and two, convergent, divergent, going away, moving away, and transform, one moving this and another moving in this, and there is no touching. If some part is there, margin at transform margin, it will broke and crack, only that much. Okay, hope you people like this video, and if you like it, please give like, comment and share this video, and also subscribe my channel Wisdom Jobs. Thank you very much.